Hey guys, welcome back. Yes, it's this bridge again. And the key that we need. Not really that difficult to find. The car's actually all the way in the back by itself, so that's a little... It makes it hard to find if you're coming from the side that we were. It can also suck if you don't know about this walkway, because if you walk down the middle, you will run through probably about 20 different anomalies. Well, unique anomalies, I should say. These are all the same. So here's the tank that we need. It is a convenient 10 kilograms. So we'll just stuff that into our pocket. And, that's a little foreboding. A bloodsucker ran right by us as soon as we got the gas tank to kill it. He was coming to get it first, but we beat him to it. I think we have a bloodsucker spy in Skadovsk. Anyway, you might notice I've got only a Desert Eagle with me. That's because this is the heaviest quest item in the game. So, just to make room, I decided to store all of our weapons and ammunition behind. And since I am a CS player, I can't just run around using my knife all the time. This is an eco round, I gotta dig up. You might not be able to see this, but there's actually no option for Noah to come with us to Pripyat. We can't ask him, which means that he can't come with us. We can suggest him to come with us to the guy when we were having our little drinking party there. But... apparently he doesn't want to go. Alright, we got the gas and canisters in place, and we get a little timer here. And, as one little last act of defiance, some bloodsuckers will run out to attack us. I think that it's a stupid non-canon move of them, because we clearly killed off every single bloodsucker in the entire game. We went to that lair and knifed all of them. After that, I'm pretty sure that news would get around the bloodsucker circuit pretty quickly not to come after the pissed off Ukraine. But oh well. Depending on your difficulty, there will be a certain amount of bloodsuckers to come out of there, and we are medium difficulty, so two came at us. The most you can have is three. And on our way back, I found the skeletal remains of his friend Joker, who you might remember him asking about at the start of the Let's Play. So, might as well tell him we found his PDA, and we will brighten up his day by letting him know that his friend is dead. They had an argument before, so he's glad that he's dead, right?
Hey, Stalker. How are you?
We are getting a whole lot done in this part, so I'll try to keep you up to date with what's going on. We just let this guy know that we found Magpie and that he is dead. He's a little disappointed, but he still gives a little bit of money anyway. And you might remember that we got a quest from, I believe his name is Tracker, who is the creepy guy in the basement in Yanov Station that watches you sleep at night. And he gave us a quest to go with these guys to hunt that chimera that nearly killed their friend that Magpie ran away from. So, we actually have to wait until about 3 o'clock in the morning before we go out and take down the chimera.
I'll be whole.
Fortunately, we can just sleep that off. Not when we got radiation, though.
I'm listening.
It's kind of an annoying thing because you're almost guaranteed to have radiation on you at some point. And I understand why they did it so that you couldn't die in your sleep due to radiation. But if you're about to die from radiation and you're that low, I don't think that that's really going to be what you're worried about is sleep.
Goodbye.
Well, I'm glad that we got the emission out of the way while we actually had to sleep it off, so... Right. Anyway, it's about time to head on out.
Careful. We gotta be real quiet. We can't let it hear us.
And as the bloodsuckers... No. Okay. I'm actually going to do this right. So that I can mess it up in another way. It's no fun if you just play the game like it's meant to go, right? I actually had to completely restart this area because when I warped in here the first time, it spawned a whole bunch of dogs. So as soon as he said we have to be quiet, they wound up hosing the dogs with shotgun and automatic gunfire.
If you see it, aim for the head. Don't get too close, though. Chimeras can smell you a mile off, even when they're sleeping.
When they're sleeping? Yeah, as we all saw, he's clearly asleep. Anyway, this is a really good introduction to chimeras, because chimeras are a new enemy that they added in for Call of Pripyat, and they're actually, apparently, the most dangerous enemy in the game. I don't really agree with that from what I've seen. Some people say they're the most dangerous because of how fast they are and how hard they hit, but they don't have nearly as much health as a pseudo-giant does. They still have a lot, but they don't have nearly as much as a pseudo-giant. But anyway, this one is wounded already, so it's going to be easy to take down. And since it's going to be easy to take down, well, I took out all those bloodsuckers. I mean, I'm pretty sure I can take down a chimera with my knife, right? When it's half dead.
It's over. Our job is done. Let's head back. Remember to pop in to see Trapper at Yanov and tell him the wounded chimera is done with to get your share.
That's actually a pretty deceptive quest because, they say that it's wounded, but are you really supposed to know that they set its health value lower? Yeah, so do not be deceived. Not all chimeras are going to be that easy to kill.
Hello. Good hunting.
The thing turned around pretty quickly against me. I guess it must have smelled all the vodka.
I'm listening.
Whoa, okay. Why do I have night vision on? Let's see, what else is there to do?
Welcome aboard our swamp.
Oh, yes. I mentioned the mechanic's other friend. We gotta go find him now. And seeing as how we are running around in these tunnels, it's probably not going to be that great for him. I'm just speeding this all up because it can take a while.
Once he's had a drink, it's better here. We need to take it easy. But then he goes and takes a run at me and Joker, saying we're young and ain't got a clue. Joker's a piece of work, too. Gets pissed off, grabs his bag, and disappears. While I was trying to calm Carden down, he left, and hell if I know where he went. And what am I supposed to do? Drink with that senile moron? No, thank you. His wookie is shit. Ugh. And to think how promising things were at the beginning.
I don't know. Your vodka tastes about the same as everybody else's. So any of you guys actually have a tape recorder that you carry around with you to bitch anytime that you have an argument with your friends? Yeah, me either. Apparently in Eastern Europe, they're a lot more open with their feelings. Wait a minute. Wrong boat. Anyway, I'm trying to wrap up this area, which actually will be doing very soon. Because, you know, it is kind of getting stale. We didn't really get to explore the last area all that much, and we will go back to it in this part. I'm just finishing up this area because, as I said earlier, there are certain things that we have to do in order to get, different endings. And there are quite a few endings. They didn't really make it how they did in Shadow of Chernobyl with this. They didn't make it to where if you have certain requirements and you'll get a certain cinematic ending. Wow. And hold on. Just complete this guy's day and let him know that his other friend is dead. Hey, we got a stash. Anyway. Sleep before this guy starts crying. Anyway. They didn't make cinematic endings for this game, like different cinematics. They kind of made different endings that build off of each other. And the endings you'll get more endings depending on what achievements you get. Not every achievement will give you a certain ending, but different achievements will give you endings, and certain events, such as missions completed, will give you different endings. Certain other things, such as if characters are alive at the end of the game, like Noah. Noah's probably the easiest ending to get, because if you don't do anything, basically the only way that you can get the ending where Noah survives is if you kill him. They made Noah's health actually pretty high, so he can't die from really anything other than you, of course. So we've already got one, maybe two special endings already. Anyway, this is a stash. He has it hidden underneath a gigantic rock, and logic would say that the easiest way to get under a rock is to go underneath it, but it takes a little bit for that logic to kick in sometimes. In my defense, smart people overthink simple problems, so I'm using that. Anyway. We just found an extremely good stash. It's got a lot of good stuff in it. It's got 45 ACP ammunition, and it's got a pistol that uses 45 ACP ammunition. It's a SIG pistol. I do not know which model, just know it's a SIG pistol, so I'll be calling it the SIG. And no, this is not to be confused with the SIG rifle. That I call the SIG, but you should know in context. And I think I found some volunteers to help try this out. Opa! That's exactly what I was thinking when I one-shot all three of you. As you can see, it's a very good pistol to get. If you can find this at the start of the game, then you are pretty well off. It's extremely accurate, does good damage against bandits, not so much against armored targets like duty and freedom members, but it'll definitely get the job done against bandits who normally tend to not have that much armor and are susceptible to pistols. In terms of where this stacks up against things like the 1911 or the Desert Eagle, I'm not really sure where it is, but I do know that it is fairly effective, as we saw. I never actually looked at the stats between the 1911, the SIG, the USP, or the Desert Eagle, but I'm just going to assume that the Desert Eagle is probably the best pistol, because it was usually the last pistol that you got unless you found it in a stash in the other two games, so I'm assuming that they let the stats stack about the same way. On my way back, I fell into a hole and found the best artifact we've seen so far. Why? Because it's actually useful. As you can see, no red effects. It is completely... it's completely beneficial to us. It gives minus 3 radiation, which means that we can use it in combination with other artifacts, so that we can have them on our belt all the time. But we don't have any anomalies or artifact slots on our armor, so we can't wear it. So I'll store it in our chest. Anyway, we can turn to the quest for killing the Chimera here, and we get a little bit more money, and we can brag to him that we killed off all the bloodsuckers. And he gives us another quest to take out 3 bloodsuckers in the swamp. Seeing as how we took out about 20 with our knife, I'm pretty sure we can take out 3 with a shotgun. I'm going to go ahead and cut over to when we get to the swamps. We've got way too much stuff to do for me to leave in all the traveling. So sorry if a lot of you guys know or like the running, but you know it's cutting out about 20 minutes from the video, so it was either this or an hour long video. Nothing really to worry about with these bloodsuckers, because they leave ripples in the water, even if they're invisible. That's 2 down. Wonder where the 3rd is. There was supposed to be a 3rd here, right? Let's check the PDA. Uh-oh, we got a runner. Just like a real cop. So now that that's done, but important stash right here. Very important stash. And it is not a normal stash either. It's not behind that door either. I should know better by now that you can only open about 1 or 2 doors in this entire game. 1 or 2 doors in this entire series. Anyway. Stuffed all the way back here is a little box with some decent stuff. But mainly, we have a note to Ghost, who you might remember as being one of Strelick's gang. And if you read the note, you can find that this is actually a note written by Strelick. This is one of 3 stashes from Strelick and his group. And it's important to find all 3 if you can. How are you supposed to know where they are? Well, there's an item that you can get to help you out, but I'm not going to. What was that? Hey! Shoot at me. Forgot Freedom was hanging out here. I'll be back. So, this is a very good quest line to go after, because as you can see, he pays well, and he gave us 3 stash coordinates for doing that very simple task. He's got something else for us, too. Take out some unknown mutants. And, that sounds interesting. I'm just gonna stash some things off, pick something up. I'm gonna drop this note in my box. Drop it in my box. Okay, well, apparently you cannot stash the notes. Anyway. I don't know what works well against unknown mutants, but I know something that'll work well against anything. Those rockets really weigh us down, so I'm gonna do a little weight management. I can't just keep on sprinting and walking and sprinting and walking. Now that I don't have anybody to share the pain with, since I'm cutting out the walking, I will actually go ahead and make an effort to make it more convenient. Very important thing. If you find that rocket in the, if you find that RPG in that stash that we did, make sure to reload it before you wind up using it. You can easily screw yourself in a fight where you go, aha, I've got an RPG, oh shit. Let me reload it real quick. And there's no quick way to reload an RPG. But first, I want to see what's in this crane. No real reason. You don't know something you guys don't know. I just feel like exploring the crane is all. Hey, there's an obvious way in. Or it looked obvious. Let's try the other side. Screw you, crane. I'll get inside you, even if it kills me. That's what I said on my last date, too. She never called back. Anyway. I actually have to climb up this dead tree here in order to jump on top of the crane. And you can drop off to get in the cabin of it. And hey, look at this. Oh, well, what do you know? Oh my goodness, isn't this a coincidence? I did not know that there was this other Strelick stash in here. Except this time it's a note to Strelick rather than from Strelick. Okay, shut up. Shut up, detector, you're getting annoying. More annoying than the night vision. Alright, let's get out of here. Got the second note. One more to go. And here we are at the bridge. Oh, jeez. I didn't know it was going to be this close quarters, otherwise I would have, not brought the RPG. Well, maybe it'll open up some. Ooh, yes, I like the look of this. Oh, hey, look, I'm here. Or at least it was. Okay. These are the unknown mutants. Everyone was so scared that they wouldn't go near here because of two bearers. Like, he stood there and he's like contemplating his death. Over. That's better. Incidentally, according to the Stalker website, Bures are prisoners that were experimented on to try to make them psychic, or whatever it is, telekinetic. Is it telekinetic? Whatever. You can move things with your mind. That. Anyway, I was in the area, so I'm just gonna grab a stash real quick. See what's in here. Wait a minute. Stash thing didn't disappear. Oh, God, there's something stuck. Alright, let me just crawl in this radioactive car and grow a second head here. Now that doesn't even help. Come on. There we go. Alright, well, I guess it was worth it for a little 45 ammunition. And, well, we've got another quest to do, so I guess we might as well do that, even though we are kind of lacking a precision weapon and this is a hostage situation. Hey, gunfire. Maybe we can find something there. Hey, and some of our friends. Maybe some duty guys. Yep, there's some duty guys here. And some zombies. Oh, come on, he was using the bathroom, Major. Have a heart. And that's really all there is as far as enemies go in this area. This area is actually kind of important because it can lead to another ending. But I don't really feel like doing it right now, so I'm just going to take a little sneak peek, kill off a few mutants in here. And I will make a mental note to come back to this area later in the LP. This place is actually kind of important. That zombie profile never gets old. And hey, it's our favorite old pistol. We just now got our precision weapon. So I think we can... looting bastards. Anyway. So I think we can now go and take care of that little hostage situation. And we're almost there, so I'll just run. Oh. And remember when I said that we would come back here later in the LP? Well,
hey,
we're coming back.
What are you doing here? Go back to where you came from while you still got legs.
Still got legs. Why is everybody threatening my legs in this game? Okay, so I almost lost my legs there, but... fortunately, I packed the super glue, so... They're managing to stay on fairly well now. Anyway, the pistol is actually working pretty well against these bandits. I'm actually really surprised at the range it's taking these guys down with. Shut up. Before any of you start saying, do you really have to walk all around this huge area and kill off every single bandit, perochialjoe? To that I say yes, yes I do, and you'll see why. Well, I actually have to wonder how this pistol is fully upgraded. I gotta try that out. I actually can't fully upgrade everything until we go to Pripyat, because you can't actually get the tools that you need in any of these areas. Not sure what he was staring at, but okay.
One more step, and he's dead.
Ha ha! Give me a second. Darn it! Okay. That was close.
Thanks for saving me.
There's probably still some people left over, but I don't really feel like taking the extra time to go clear up this area. Besides, he just picked up an AK, he's fine. Now that I think back about that, I really probably could have killed that guy with my shotgun. I mean, this shotgun, it doesn't really have that much spread, so it's good enough to where you'd be able to take people out pretty well. Okay. Yes. See why I have to clear everybody out? Because there's a guy all the way over here. This guy refuses to move and just stares at him through the wall before he will move out. But at least GST Game World,
I'll meet you by the old train station.
Was pretty considerate when they were doing this. So we can actually just head on out with this guy and he will take us right back to the Anov station. Now we can talk to his friends and get a reward. And hey, look at that. We got an achievement. And that achievement is
how
actually
goes the
pretty hunt? Nice. You know how freedom likes to attack us for no reason? And we're surrounded by stalkers who don't really help? We've helped out so many stalkers that now that we've got our reputation up to where really any stalker will come by and help us when we're being attacked. So we don't have to worry about freedom sneaking up behind us. And off camera, there are quite a few instances where we'll be walking, and freedom will be walking with some neutral stalkers, and they'll all be happy. Freedom will turn around, shoot one shot at me, and they will drop them in an instant. So I don't even have to pull my gun out when I am up against freedom anymore. It's pretty cool that they added in those achievements for doing certain things, and you'll get rewards for it. There are some very good rewards you can get, too. We will actually be seeing one of those in this video. And ignore the fact that I just pulled out the sniper rifle, because we won't be using it. At least not yet. So don't get too excited. I'm actually just going to head out and get my, I'm going to get the stash that's nearby here, and we'll get a little message.
Hey, it's Trapper. I just had a hunter here who saw a chimera last night. Judging by the description, it's the same one we're after. Come see me if you can. It's important.
So I don't know if you guys remember his little backstory, but one of his hunting friends was killed off by a chimera, and this is apparently the chimera that killed his friend. Shut up, Hawaii.
See you.
Howdy.
This is the last quest in the quest line for Trapper. This is the Night Hunt quest. And we, as it might sound, have to go out at night to take out this chimera. By ourselves, by the way. So for this, I don't know. We haven't really experienced a full health. Full health chimera before, so it's best to just prepare for the worst and get the SIG. I'm kind of just checking for damage right now. In all honesty, if I go up against something with a lot of health, I'm probably going to be using the shotgun. This has gotten much higher damage, and the fact that we can make it automatic can be very helpful. Especially when aiming for the head, since we can move around with it, and that doesn't affect the accuracy at all. Okay, you guys ready for this? I went to the upgrader, upgraded the shotgun all the way, upgraded my body armor all the way to have extra protection against this guy. Nah, I'm just gonna knife it. Must have been some pretty shitty hunters if they died to that. And they had guns, too. So, I'm actually pretty sure that I did not avenge his friend's honor at all. I'm pretty sure I just shamed his friend way more than dying did. Oh, the hunt goes pretty well, man. Did I tell you that I knifed it? Anyway, we got the Predator shotgun and a lot of money. And two achievements. Predator shotgun is a pump-action shotgun that is very special. It has got extremely high damage, even more damage than what we've got right now on our shotgun. The first achievement we got is for getting 100,000 rubles. It will open up some more items with some merchants. The other one that we got was for finishing Trapper's quest line. We will get a random amount of random ammunition in our box every single day, which is very, very nice. And apparently it also spawns chimeras at night, so by making it safer, we made it more dangerous. Go figure. Don't ever shoot me again. Oh, and I found something interesting. You can put a scope on your shotgun. I am happy. I am so happy about that. Anyway, thanks a lot for watching, guys. I will see you in the next part.